to be in the house of God this morning. Amen.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and
what he did for you. Amen.
There is a prophetic word found in Isaiah chapter 9 that often the Christmas season is inaugurated with this verse and the verses around it. But I want to read this one verse this morning, Isaiah 9:2. The people walking in darkness have seen a great light. Of those living in the land of deep darkness, a light has dawned. The scripture says, John, in writing his gospel account, in that first chapter of John, he says that Jesus came as a light into the darkness, and there were many who were present when he first came to this earth, and they did not recognize him for who he was. But as many as believed on him, God gave them the right to become the children of God. It's an incredible thing when Jesus steps into our lives and the Spirit brings us to this holy awareness of who He is and the promise that He brings to our lives. I'm thankful for Jesus reaching into my darkness, and I know you are as well. The other evening, someone handed me a note to read. Someone had written them a note, and it was an encouraging word, and they wanted to share it with me. We were in the front hallway, and we were standing in the shadows, and I'm at that point in life, I need to get in the light if I'm going to read something. And so I said, let me step over here in the light and read this. And you remember last week I told you about Jones in that book that I've been reading, The Noticer, and he said it's a shame to lose everything while you're chasing after nothing. And he says something else in his book that I wanted to share with you this morning. The first time he encountered the young man who is one of the main characters of the book, when he approaches him for the very first time, this young fella is living underneath a pier. And he's in the shadows, and Jones has showed up in his life. And the first thing that he said to this young man who was huddled up underneath this pier, he said, step out into the light. And he wanted to have an opportunity to see him and for him to be able to see Jones clearly in the light. But as you read the book, you come to realize that that was truly the main byline that Jones had to offer. He was always calling people to step out into the light. And God is calling us to do the same. Stepping into the light has to do with more than illumination that a light bulb can give. Spiritually, stepping into the light has to do with you and I opening ourselves to the truth about life, to the truth about who God is, about who we are, who our neighbor is, and how all of that is to fit together. And God truly, in the Christmas season, is calling us to step into this light that we know to be Jesus, that we might find ourselves and that we might find life in all of its fullness. The Christmas story in a verse is this verse. God loved the world so much that He gave His one and only Son as the payment for our sins, so that whoever believes in Jesus and what He did for us on the cross shall not perish but have eternal life. The essence of the Christmas story is that, first of all, God loves us. That is a life-changing reality. When we come to realize that not because of what we've done, but because of who He is, He loves us. There's nothing we've done that has earned that favor. He bestows that favor. As a matter of fact, in the Old Testament, it says that for Abraham, his faith was credited to him as righteousness. When he saw God, when he heard God, he made the decision that he would go after God with all of his heart. And it was that faith response to the light that God brought to his life that allowed righteousness to be born in Abraham's life and in his experience. Everything changed for him, and the story continues through the Scripture. Everyone who has ever responded to the light that God brings to their lives, it makes all of the difference in the world. It's a refreshing thing to step out of the shadows, if you will. It's a refreshing thing to step out of the things that have kept us imprisoned in our lives. Those skeletons in our closet, to be set free of them is an incredible thing, and the light of Christ shines in our lives in such a way that it brings us to that opportunity. God loved us so much that He gave His one and only Son to be the payment for our sin. No one else could make that payment because no one else has been born of a virgin and has God as his or her father. Jesus is the only one, and God sent him as his only son to make that payment for sin for us, that we might have the opportunity to find life and to find it for all of eternity. He is a gift from God's hand. And it is in receiving this gift that we are set free from the things that threaten to destroy us. And believe me, Satan is doing everything that he can do to destroy each and every one of us. But God has sent his Son, and the Bible says, greater is he, Jesus, who is in us, than he who is in the world. And so there is a salvation available to us because of this light of God that has come into the world. And I pray that you and I are opening ourselves to that light each and every day. An incredible thing to be able to step into a relationship with God because of the forgiveness that is offered and find a forever fellowship that the world has not given us and the world cannot take away from us. What a beautiful season to celebrate the life that God has offered. We go in search of just the right gifts for our loved ones. And some of our searching is still done in stores. A lot of it's done online. It's incredible how much shopping is happening by way of Amazon and such sites. And we go looking for just that right thing. And now that things are so readily available for us, by way of online shopping, it's incredible how, I'm just going to get this one more thing. Are you experiencing that? You've got it all wrapped up, but then you see this and you think, I'm going to go ahead and get that. And Amazon, by way of USPS, United States Postal Service, will have it here in a couple of days, still in time for Christmas. And we're doing everything we can to put all those gifts together to offer to those we love. We don't have to give, we want to give. That's true of God. He didn't have to, he wanted to. Because he loves us. We don't have to open our presents. We want to open our presents. We wouldn't dare think of leaving anything unopened this Christmas, or any Christmas for that matter. We're going to open the gifts that have been placed under the tree for us. As we grow up, we experience the reality that it is really a greater joy to give than it is to receive. What's better than watching your kids or your grandkids open that gift of love that you have wrapped up to offer to them in this season? How incredible is it to watch the children as they go on Christmas morning many times while it's still dark to find what Santa has left for them by the tree? It's an incredible season, a season of giving, and God is the one who gave first by offering His Son Jesus to each and every one of us. I pray that we enjoy our family gatherings this Christmas and that we enjoy those times of giving and receiving the gifts of love that have been offered. I pray that you as a family will take opportunity to gather around the Christmas story. That's what Christmas Eve service is all about here at First Church. It's about us taking one more opportunity after everything's been done, before those family celebrations begin to happen on Christmas Eve leading into Christmas Day, to have one more opportunity to come into God's house and to gather around the truth that when Jesus gave His life on the cross, that is the ultimate gift. As a matter of fact, the Apostle Paul writes in 1 Corinthians 15 that Jesus is God's indescribable gift. It is amazing what has happened in our lives because God has given His Son Jesus to each and every one of us. And so we come together and we take communion, we listen to some Christmas music, and we just tune our spirits as we move into that very next day that we've been leading up to through this Advent season. And what a time it is as God's Spirit meets us here in His house. And that's a gift that I pray will not leave unopened, that we'll take opportunity to be a part of that very special worship occasion. God wants us to know how much He loves us. He wants us to know that He has everything we need, and He offers that through His Son Christ. And God wants us to have more than we ever thought possible, more than we could even think to ask for. And it's all found in Jesus. He sent His Son, born of a virgin, laid in a manger, walking on water, healing every manner of sickness, forgiving every kind of transgression, and then allowed him to be nailed to a cross, all of that, to pay our sin debt for us, that we might be set free, that we might have the opportunity to walk out of the darkness and into the light. If God had not sent Jesus, we would not have that opportunity. There would be no way that we could step out of the sin that has entangled us if it were not for Jesus. And I pray that as you are observing this Christmas season, that you are once again, or maybe for the very first time, opening your heart to Jesus. That you would find through a personal experience of God's grace as He's reaching into your life, what this season of love is really all about. I enjoy all the Christmas songs. I enjoy the secular Christmas songs, the sacred Christmas songs. I enjoy the excitement that builds in children's lives because of Santa Claus and all that's come to mean in their experience. But most of all, I enjoy the reality that God put on flesh and came to be right in the middle of us, that we might be redeemed, that we might be bought back from all that threatens to tear us away from God. Not only for a time, but remember, Satan's doing everything he can to separate us from God for all of eternity, and God has countered that through His Son, Jesus Christ. I want you to think of this morning. Eternity is waiting for you. And for some, eternity is closer than for others, but eternity is waiting for each and every one of us. Now that can sound morbid and negative, but it's not. We were created to be forever in the presence of God, to find our fullest existence by being in fellowship with Him for all of eternity. That's what we were created for. And eternity is waiting for our arrival. And eternity understands from that heavenly perspective what we are holding to by faith. But the reality is, all the angels in glory and those who have gone before us know how amazing it is to step from this side to the other side. And Jesus stepped from the other side to this side to give us that opportunity. The Bible says He became sin for us that we might become the righteousness of God. Step into the light. Understand that all of us need Jesus. Not just some of us, but all of us need Him. And what He is offering us through His sacrifice and through His resurrection from death. Just as He walked out of the grave, one day we will walk out of the grave because of the love that God has poured out in our lives through His Son. And so really, for Christians, when we say to one another, Merry Christmas, what we are saying to one another is how glorious it is that we have been given the opportunity to know God through His Son, Jesus. What an incredible thing. The shepherds, the Bible says, were in their fields by night, tending their sheep. And the angel of God appeared unto them and says, I bring you great news that is filled with joy and peace. A Savior has been born unto you this day in Bethlehem, and He is Christ the Lord. Jesus has been reborn in my heart this Christmas. God has, all through this season, we started the season by saying, may God put an angel in your life that will guide you to the manger. God's done that in my life. I pray that you've experienced the same, and I believe you have. And today, may we be determined not only during this season, but all through our lives to step into the light of the truth of who God is and what He has for us. Don't be blinded by your enemy, Satan. step into the light and let God bring the fullness of His salvation to your experience. Let's pray. Father, we recognize this morning it was a holy night when that angel chorus appeared in the skies and announced to the shepherds the birth of the King. Lord, I pray that You would bring Your light to bear in our lives, that we might see You, but Lord, that in seeing You, that we might also see ourselves, and that we might be set free from the religious confusion about how a person comes into relationship with You. Lord, You are the one who has drawn us to Yourself through Jesus, Your Son. And just as we would not dare leave a gift offered by a loved one under the tree this Christmas, Lord, help us to not leave Jesus in the manger. Help us to open our hearts to the great light that He is wanting to bring to our lives, to help us to see and experience the salvation that has been purchased by the shedding of His own blood. Lord, I pray that this morning it would be one more opportunity for us to draw close to You and to let go of the things that would keep us from You, that Your great salvation might be worked out in our personal experience. Lord, for that one this morning who is struggling, I pray that You would reach to them in spiritual fashion in such a way that they might know that it is you touching their souls and drawing them near. Lord, for that one who is sad, I pray that You would bring the gladness of Christ to their hearts. For that one who is confused and not knowing what is going to happen next, I pray that You would bring to them the peace that passes understanding because of Your presence. Help us, Lord, to step into the light, that we might see You, that we might see ourselves, that we might see others from heaven's perspective. A great light is dawning in our darkness. May we receive that light. I ask in Jesus' name, amen.